Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we will discuss how to apply linear equations and inequations in one variable in real life. First of all, let us discuss solving and creating equations. Now suppose we are given a trapezoid having area is equal to 54 centimeters square. Now here sides B1 and B2 are parallel to each other, and here we are given B1 is equal to 10 centimeters. Also we are given height H is equal to 6 centimeters, and here we have to find length of side B2, that is we have to find B2 here. Now we know that area of trapezoid is equal to 1 by 2 into height of the trapezoid, that is H, into B1 plus B2 the whole. Here B1 and B2 are the two parallel sides of this trapezoid. Now we can write this as area A is equal to 1 by 2 into H into B1 plus B2 the whole. Now we have to set up an equation to find the length of base B2. First of all, we will multiply this equation on both sides by 2. So we have 2 into A is equal to 2 into 1 by 2 into H into B1 plus B2 the whole. This implies 2A is equal to H into B1 plus B2 the whole. Now we will divide both sides of this equation by H. So we have 2A upon H is equal to H into B1 plus B2 the whole all upon H, and this further implies 2A upon H is equal to B1 plus B2. Now we will subtract B1 from both sides of this equation. So we have 2A upon H minus B1 is equal to B1 plus B2 minus B1, and this further implies 2A upon H minus B1 is equal to B2. So this is the required equation. Let this be equation 1. Now in this equation we will put A is equal to 54 centimeters square, H is equal to 6 centimeters, and B1 is equal to 10 centimeters. So putting these values, we have 2 into 54 whole upon 6 minus 10 is equal to B2. Now we know that 2 into 3 is 6, and 3 into 18 is 54. So this implies 18 minus 10 is equal to B2. This further implies B2 is equal to 8. So B2 is equal to 8 centimeters. So B1 is equal to 10 centimeters. Height H is equal to 6 centimeters, and B2 is equal to 8 centimeters. Now while writing a linear equation, we have to model the given situation with an algebraic model. For this, relate all parts of the problem by identifying the actions that suggest operations. Then we define one or more variables to represent the unknown. And then we write the algebraic model that represents the action using the variables and the operations. And after constructing the algebraic model, we solve each variable if possible. Now let us see an illustration which uses algebraic model. Now, you start with $20 and save $6 each week. How many weeks will it take to save $200? Now let us start with its solution. Now let us use algebraic model. First, we have to relate all the parts of the problem. Now here, total amount saved equals starting amount plus amount saved each week times number of weeks. So where we have related all the parts of the given problem. Now let us define what is given to us. Now here, unknown is number of weeks. So let it be W. Now here, total amount saved is $200 equals starting amount, that is $20, plus amount saved each week, that is $6, times number of weeks, that is W. And now we write the algebraic model that represents the action using the variables and operations. So we have $200 is equal to $20 plus $6 into W. Now let us solve this equation formed. So we have 200 is equal to 20 plus 6 into W. Now we will subtract 20 from both sides of this equation. And here we have 200 minus 20 is equal to 20 plus 6W minus 20, which implies 180 is equal to 6W. Now dividing both sides of this equation by 6, we have 180 upon 6 is equal to 6W upon 6. Further, on solving this, now we know that 6 into 1 is 6 and 6 into 30 is 180. So we have 30 is equal to W. Thus, it will take 30 weeks to save $200. Now we use the similar method of modeling a linear inequality and solving it. Now let us see the following illustration. Samantha wants to earn $29 to buy an outfit. Her mother agrees to pay her $6 an hour for gardening in addition to her $5 weekly allowance for helping around the house. What is the minimum number of hours Samantha must work at gardening to receive at least $29 this week? Let us first understand the problem. We are given that Samantha's weekly allowance is $5. She will get $6 per hour for gardening, and we have to find the minimum number of hours she will have to work to receive at least $29. Now see, at least means the minimum amount. It means amount will be greater than or equal to $29. So here sign will be of greater than or equal to. Now first of all, let us relate all parts of the given problem. Now here, Samantha's weekly allowance plus amount earned per hour by gardening times number of hours is at least $29. So we have related all parts of the given problem. Now next, we define what is given to us here. We have to find number of hours, that is, the unknown here is number of hours. So let it be denoted by H. So Samantha's weekly allowance, that is $5 plus amount earned per hour by gardening, that is $6, times number of hours, that is H, is at least $29. Now let us write the variables and substitute values. So it is $5 plus $6 into H is at least. Now for at least we'll use the sign of greater than or equal to $29. Now let us solve this inequality. Now 5 plus 6H is greater than or equal to 29. Now subtract 5 from both sides. So we have 5 plus 6H minus 5 is greater than or equal to 29 minus 5. This implies 6H is greater than or equal to 24. Now let us divide both sides of this inequality by 6. So this implies 6H upon 6 is greater than or equal to 24 upon 6. Now here, since we are dividing by a positive number, so the inequality remains same. Now this implies H is greater than or equal to, now 6 into 4 is 24. So we get H is greater than or equal to 4. So minimum number of hours Samantha must work to receive at least $29 is 4. Now let us check our result. For this, put H is equal to 4 in this inequality. So we have 5 plus 6 into 4 is greater than or equal to 29, which implies 5 plus 24 is greater than or equal to 29, and this implies 29 is greater than or equal to 29, which is true. Thus, our answer is correct. So in this session, we have discussed how to apply linear equations and inequations in real life. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.